Yo, what's up, everyone? It's your boy. Welcome back to another video. I'm hyped for this video. This video is going to be the Pen God playing Performapal against three YugiTubers. Who's going to come out on top? Who are the YugiTubers? Stay tuned for the whole video and find out. If you guys want to support the channel, don't forget to check out down below the beautiful Performapal Skullcrobat Joker playmat. And guess what? We're not just playing Performapals, baby. We're playing Magician and Zephyros and Magispectors too. That's right. So smash the subscribe button and check your beautiful playmats down below. You guys gotta smash the subscribe button because when we hit 40,000 subscribers, you guys are gonna get Performapal videos in real life too. You guys want real life videos? You guys want real life videos? Smash the subscribe button. Anyways, you guys are hyped for this video. Get ready, because it's time to take down three YouTubers with the best deck pendulums. And our first victim, likes feet. Let's go, baby. Pepe time! Before we get into this absolute onslaught of Cough Cough Farfa, don't forget to sign up on Patreon down below. Today's video on Patreon, I'm doing a good one. I'm actually announcing what I think is the most underrated engine in Yu-Gi-Oh! After Pendulums. So you can see the second most underrated. So go check that out on Patreon down below. It's just $10 a month and you guys can figure that out. And I post videos there every day. So let's get it. On to the video. Let's go, boys. We're going to start a YugiTube onslaught right now. Let's go. Make some noise. Because your boy's going to need some energy. First victim of the day is none other than the foot-looking god himself, Farfa. And in honor of facing Farfa, I decided to also not just play Performapal in my deck, but also throw in some Magispectors. Because I'm pretty sure the same people that like feet are the same people that like animals. Not in a good way. Let's destroy this guy, okay? Let's destroy this guy. Oracle of Zephra, Nekomata, Bambuku, Celestial Magician, and Zephyr Providence. So instantly, I don't see Harmonizing or Pendulum Sorcerer, and I'm pretty fucking disappointed. But you know what? It's all good. We're going to make the most of this. We got normal Bambuku to be able to Pendulum Summon our Fox. We get Tornado, and here's what we have. So this here gives us three traps. Gives us Tornado, gives me nine pillars, and then Providence will search the other trap. All three will be usable, but I have an extra Magispector. So I'm obviously just going to XYZ these. I know what he was playing, otherwise I'd go into Dweller. So I'm going to go into Baguska here. And I'm going to set three. I'm going to go set three traps. And then I search Harmonizing at the end phase. And I'm going to, on my turn, I'm going to just Pendulum Summon a Harmonizing. He goes now. He passes because he couldn't deal with the Babuska. Looking at his hand, he could Lightning Storm. Obviously, I would negate it. Using nine pillars. Which one does he know I have? My turn now. This deck is really hard to kill. So I definitely misplayed putting Babuska here. I changed this build up a little bit to fit up my Magispectors as well. I'll be posting the list tomorrow probably, but here he scoops before I could kill him with my strong power move of Cowboy, and it's okay. I'm going to Cowboy him for game next turn. Let's go. So now he decides to go second still. He's playing Go Second Madolche deck. I guess that's his strategy. Here I open no Magispectors, which is fine. You're not always going to open one of each. I think opening a hand of one Performapal, one Magispector, one Magician, or one Zephyra is fucking... that's fucking broken. Like, it's too good to be true. Here, we open three of the four, so that's good enough. This is going to end up with an Unbreakable board regardless. I save the Zephyrath, popping that, knowing I'm going to Normal Summon. And this is the idea. I told you guys this the other day. So I told you guys yesterday that the whole point of Second Donkey is literally just another Joker. You use Sork to pop it, and you don't use your Normal Summon in this deck. So you just Normal Summon it after. And just like this, we have two free rank fours. I'm going to do the Dryden play. Where Dryden will be able to pop anything, just in case you get rid of my Baguska. I'm gonna have Dryden to pop the normal summon, which really hurts. There's nothing I could have made. If I go Baguska, it hurts my other rank 4 as well, obviously. I could have gone Time Start to search something, but this is just better for me. This just ensures that I'm going to be able to, just in case he gets rid of Baguska, I could have another interruption as well as my counter trap. So we'll see what he does here. He starts off with Extravagance. I'm going to negate that, obviously. And then he goes Reboot. And I'm like, okay, that's fine. Whatever. I still have Baguska. He ends up not drawing anything. Looking at his hand right now, he should have actually let that go. If he let that go, he needs to use his talents. The only way, and in fact, if this is a misplay of my end to even negate the Extravagance, I should have only used Extravagance as something that negates Baguska. But if he lets me negate the Extravagance, and then my Zephyr Nui effect will go off to add a card, then he uses talents to steal Baguska, And then he has all these cards against one Dryden. I'm pretty sure he'll be able to defeat it. Oh, he has Salon. He could definitely defeat it. So he could have won with that. Not won. Madoka doesn't do shit. He would have cleared my board, and then I would have OTK him with five cards in my hand. So victim number one of the day. See ya, Farfa. Next up, we're going to face none other than the best player in Europe, in my opinion. That is Gabe Soucy, who has an amazing channel as well for French people. So aujourd'hui, bonjour, Sylva bien. Match number two. But I did ask, when I faced Gabe, I told him let's play some fun decks. Let's play some fun decks. So he opted to play Arm Dragon, which obviously is not on the tier of Magic Spectres. I mean, no deck is on the tier of Magic Spectres. But I obviously have a big advantage here by playing a better deck. I have Magicians in my deck. I have Zephyr cards in my deck. On top of the Magic Spectres and my Performer Pal cards. So I'm at a big advantage here. I did ask him to play like a fun deck. We're playing fun decks for fun. So I don't consider this a real win against my boy Gabe, who is on my team for the LCS. We're going to fucking destroy everyone. No one stands a chance. Anyways, let's go. He asked my first card, my Magic Spectre, I believe. I'm going to pen summon here. I use it as a bait. And I'm going to search. And then at this point, I'm going to definitely XYZ my Fox because, like, what? Like, I can't use a card for it. And here, I want to bring something up to you guys. So it looks here that I have no card in my extra deck. How the fuck am I going to have a grind game? But that's the beauty of Celestial Magician. And this is why this deck needs Celestial Magician right now. It's you put up, you XYZ all your cards, none of them go back to the extra deck. Celestial Magician and Zephyr Nui staying on the field gives you another card in hand next turn, and Celestial gives you another card. So you have two cards, even if you pen your whole hand. Plus, by time start adding is three, plus drawing is four. So if you have Sork, you'll get five cards in hand, so it's very important. Anyways, so this is his hand, his extravagance. I'm going to negate this, I believe. All right, yeah, I go Dweller in the standby phase, and then I negate the extravagance. I don't know what his deck does. And he goes Tempest to pop my Dryden. I'll protect my Dryden. And what Arm Dragon does, Arm Dragon's basically like a slightly shittier version of Dragon Maid. It still is, it's not the worst deck. It's a control deck. It kind of does what Dragon Maid does, in a sense, kind of. So they all get value from Tempest and Lightning Dragon Ruler by sending from hand to grave. They all get effects when sent from hand to grave. So it's pretty cool. Here I'm going to go for game. But is it game, boys? Is it now? I hit him for 7,500 or something along those lines. And yeah, guys, you can't come back from this. The way I built this deck is if you can't kill me turn one, I win. And then I had to hit him with the cowboy for game. I hit him with the cowboy for game because we got to flex on our opponents, boys. Let's go. Here he goes first, starts off with extravagance. So we'll see where this goes here. I'm going to end up just going to wait and see what he has. He plays called by fearing a hand trap. I don't play any hand traps. And then at this moment, I'm going to Pendulum Summon, and it was just over at this point. All he had was Seal, and what I did was I Pendulum Summon everything first. He hits that, and he could have Droll at the very end, but like there was no point at that. Like he's getting OTK'd here, so this is just game at this moment. There's nothing he could do. I'm going to Trapeze Magician for game here. There's nothing he could do to protect himself. He couldn't even Ash anything there. Nothing mattered. At this moment, I thought to myself, you know what? I'm not going to kill him. I have so much advantage. Like, I'm just going to, just in case. I don't know what this deck plays, man. I don't know what Arm Dragon. I don't know anything about Arm Dragons. So I just opted not to. And he couldn't act. The only thing he could Ash is the one thing I didn't give a fuck about. So it didn't matter for me at all. And then, yeah, so that was game. GG's there with my boy Gabe. Obviously, this deck sucks. Like, Arm Dragon, he probably would have beat me with another deck. Gabe's probably one of the duelists that I respect the most in the world. We're going to go now to match number three. This is going to be against Crush Cards. My dogs at Crush Cards is going to be Magic Spectre Pepe versus Eldritch Dragoon. So this is definitely the most meta deck we're facing today. So send your energy, boys. This is going to be a tough matchup. And they're going first. Or a trap deck's going first. He is playing a trap deck that's very good against the meta. Not so good against a combo deck like Pendulums. And you know what? These cards like Debunk and Transmigration Prophecy, they're fucking amazing. I play both of these in my trap deck. You guys know I play Eldritch as well. I play both of these because Transmigration Prophecy shuts down Drytron, shuts down Eldritch, really hurts Virtual World, especially the new version of Virtual World that they play. This is extremely good against them. And Debunk also banishes Golden Lord, banishes Drytron, banishes anything in Virtual World from hand. Like, all these cards are meant for the meta, but against Pendulums, this is why I'm saying Pendulums are a fucking really good call this format because Skullmeisters will be dead, DD Crows will be dead, Ghost Spells will be dead. This is a fucking amazing meta call, man. Amazing meta call. You can't use any of those three cards. Meister's fucking dead. Bell is dead. Crow is dead. All these cards are fucking dead against this deck. So it's amazing. I Pendulum Summon. He's going to end up Torrentialing, but that's okay because all my cards will resolve. That's all I care about. He waited for Harmonizing Effect to summon first. And then, yeah, he'll Torrential everything. I guess he wanted Haquero in the graveyard, which is fine. And I'm just going to have two traps and pass. Like, this, I only use one trap on his turn, but I set the other for the following. And he's playing Eldritch, so he goes inside. I'm like, fuck. I still negate the Red Eyes Fusion, which is all I needed. I don't want Red Eyes Dragoon to touch the board. And in this scenario, you know, he's going to get Conquistador. And this is fine. I'm gonna play this very safe here. Look at this. This is why I'm saying that the new Pepe is fucking broken. So old Pendulums will have zero cards in hand. My board just got Torrentialed. But I have four cards in hand to start my turn. Like, that's fucking insane. I got Torrentialed my last turn. Can you guys understand that? I got Torrentialed last turn. And I still have four cards in hand. Like, that's just fucking ridiculously good. So I know he doesn't have another Torrential because unless he opened one of these or Torrential. If you open two, I go straight into Tornado Dragon to pop the Conquistador when he activates it. And now I'm going to go into Ignister to pop my Purple Poison, to pop one of the shuffle one of the middle cards. I pop Tornado when he chains it. I'm going to use Ignister to shuffle one of the middles. And then Poison will pop the Golden Lord. I use Juggler Effect here to search Trick Clown. I did not use my Normal Summon this turn. So I'm going to Normal Summon. I calculate damage. I took out Trapeze Magician. No, sorry, I still have Trapeze Magician in this version, but I couldn't make it with Donkey. So I could have had game right here for sure. But he also has Scarlet. So I'm like, you know what? I'm just going to let him do everything. I'm going to attack as much as possible. Just in case, I don't think I could OTK to Scarlet. Just in case I have such advantage, there's no reason to rush things. I do have a counter trap. I could have negate the Scarlet, you know. So you know what? If I XYZ the Donkey and not the Celestial, and Celestial and Trick Clown made Trapeze, I had game by just using Zhang Xing on Scarlet. But I also don't know what the other card is. So I don't want to risk it by not knowing the other card. I'm just going to kill this and go with the Dweller. And then just auto win. Like, there's nothing he could do to beat me. I'm going to get some plus here. And I'm just going to end phase Celestial. You guys see this? Like, it's not only that I defeat him. I have all the advantage. It's just like, there's nothing you can do. I have advantage every turn. I get all these plus every single turn. So here he's going to go Extravagance and Insight. So it's a very good combo here for him. Very good for him here. Very good. He goes Red Eyes Fusion here. And, well, he sets three, so we'll see how this goes. I go evenly. This is a bait, so I can play with my other cards. And we'll see what his other traps are. He's gonna fucking kill me with the strike. This is classic, boys. This is classic. Striking a fucking Pendulum Summon. At that moment, I'm like, yeah, GG's. Let's go game three. So you can't do anything with the strike in this deck. Strike really kills this version of my deck. He opens really good here. As Extravagance, double Red Eyes Fusion, two Eldritch cards. This is really good for him. I can only negates this deck puts up are my trap negates, and I only have one this hand. So we'll see how this is gonna end up. This game three is gonna be a fucking incredible game. You guys see the power of second donkey here again is fucking amazing. I plus like crazy here is why I love this deck so much. Look at all this plus, man. It is so powerful. I go Time Star to search Harmonizing. I go Drynet to pop my Zephyr Nui. I send a Trick Clown. Trick Clown's effect summons itself back to the field. I get another rank four out. I go into, I get another Drydent. Look at this. Like, here I go into Tornado Dragon because I know what he's playing. I go into F-Zero Dragon. It's not legal at the moment, but, you know, it doesn't matter. It's playing for fun. And what this card does is it fucking takes care of Dragoon very simply. I have no other way to out the Dragoon unless I went fucking Baguska and have all my cards be dead. But I didn't want to do that. You could also pop that by so many ways. So I'm going to end on a board of F-Zero, Utopic F-Zero Dragon, Drydent, Tornado Dragon, and Nine Pillars. My reasoning is if he goes Eldritch, Curse Eldland, I use Drydent to pop Curse Eldland. I use Tornado to pop his sets that he goes. This will stop a Dragoon effect. Nine Pillars will stop the Dragoon. So this is what I'm trying to do here, and we'll see how it goes. Celestial effect, and look at this. Like, it's not just that I have an insane board. It's also that I have three cards in hand, set scales. Zephyr Nui is going to add me a spell card. I have four cards. I'm going to start my turn with five cards. That's what I fucking love about this deck. He goes Extravagance here, and this is just fucking insane for him. There's nothing I can do with this hand. His hand is fucking bananas. His hand's fucking crazy good. So, he has Golden Lord and these. He does make a misplay here. Well, I think he used Lord to send Scarlet. He should not have done that because he doesn't know how this is going to turn out. He doesn't know how the whole end board is going to turn out. What I would have done was send a Red Eyes Fusion, send a Waquero. I would have sent a Waquero. Keep it guaranteeing that you have a Conk and a Scarlet. Guaranteed no matter what. So I would have done that for sure. Here I'm going to negate that because he's going to use it to send this to the graveyard. This card cannot be destroyed by battle or effects, Utopic F-Zero Dragon, but it could be sent to the grave. So I have to negate it. I also was debating Nine Pillarsing and then having Utopic stop the Dragoon he brings out, but he could. It's not enough, because if I negate the effect, he'll negate Dragoon's effect, so I can't do that. I have to pray here that he doesn't open two Red Eyes Fusions, which he did. He has three Red Eyes Fusions, actually. I negate one of them, which he proceeds to summon another Red Eyes Fusion. So I was very unlucky. Nothing I can do in that scenario. So he puts that up. I use Dryden on my own card, so I don't take damage. He pops. He sets. Now, this is where he makes a misplay. What he should have done was... he has a Conk. He should have send one of his Golden Lands to the graveyard to add Golden Lord to hand. This also saves you a card for Lord to Dragoon send. And on top of that, you'll be able to get Scarlet and Conquistador on the field, because Conk will banish and get Scarlet. That's what he should have done. Anyways, so my turn now. I normal Celestial. It hits the 3k attack because there's XYZ on the field. And I attack Dragoon. Kills both. I attack for 3k. He protects it, and that's fine. I kill it. And now I can actually go do some damage. I go Zephyroth to send Zephyrnui, and I'm going to go put up even more negates here. I don't want to summon too much just in case he has something. I also make sure to have exactly two rank 4s I'm going to have. I go Dweller. I don't know why I summoned the Sork. I think I should have summoned the Zephyr Thumen as well, because that could have given me another rank 4. I go Dweller because I don't want Lord to summon. I don't want Conk to get his effect. And mainly, I don't want Wyvern to get an effect. He draws another Red Eyes Fusion here, which is a downside of playing Red Eyes cards. And at this moment, it's all hopes lost for him. I'm going to go for game here. I'm going to Pendulum of Sword to get even more plus. Normal on Donkey. Look at this scenario here. I have 4 cards in hand. I have all these cards on the field. I actually can't lose in this scenario at all. I go Selene, Trick Clown, Access Code, Effective Trick Clown, Summon Baguska. I can only kill one card. I just go for game here. He has 2 Golden Lands, but that's not going to do anything. In terms of saving him the game, he's gonna protect this, I believe, and that's fine. If you guys look at this scenario, in fact, I could have negated that. I go Zeus just for shits and gigs, and there's nothing you can do. I have one more Dweller here. I go Dweller, even if he goes LN, that's totally fine. He'll have 400, he'll have one Golden Lord left. He'll use Golden Lord's effect here to pop. I negate it with this, and there's just nothing he could do in this scenario. That's all he had. I had a Divine Strike, and this is the beauty. It's a masterclass of what Pepe could do right now. If you guys saw, every turn you put up 2 rank 4s and you end with 4 cards in hand. This is an every turn type of thing. Pepe is most definitely not dead. Pepe 2021 is better than Pepe 2014, whenever the fuck that shit came out. Anyways, hope you guys enjoyed this. That's 2019 or something. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Hope you guys smash the subscribe button as well. We're almost at 40,000 subscribers. And guess what, boys? Guess what? Pen best deck, Pepe best deck. And we'll see you guys in the next video. Peace!